Hello everyone, my name is Govardhan Rao, Assistant Professor in Tripathi Department at St. Martin's Engineering College. Today I am going to discuss about a full wave rectifier with an R load.
Okay. Full wave rectifier with R load. So, before going to construct a full wave rectifier, we need to know about a normal SCR. SCR stands for silicon controlled rectifier. Okay, silicon controlled rectifier. This is an electronic element which is having four layered three junction device. Okay, which is having four layered three junction device. Out of that, normally in a symbolic way, it can be represented like this. This is an anode, cathode and gate pulse. Coming to the operation of the anode, cathode and the gate pulse, the anode is in a positive, cathode is in a negative, and gate pulse, that because of having the gate pulse, it is called as an a controllable device. Okay, SCR is an, a controllable four layered three junctional device. Okay, now coming to the normal operation of an SCR, if we connect this SCR, for example, this is our SCR, right? Okay, if we connect this SCR to a forward bias condition, that means the anode is connected to the positive terminal of the battery and the cathode is connected to the negative terminal of the battery, then the SCR or the thyristor is connected in forward bias condition. Okay, when thyristor is connected in forward bias condition, it is ready to conduct, is nothing but forward operating mode. Okay, that is forward operating mode, it is not forward conducting mode. How it represents? Normally this SCR will operate in three modes. One is reverse blocking state, forward blocking state, forward conducting state. This stage is called as a forward blocking stage. Why? Because anode is connected to the positive terminal, cathode is connected to the negative terminal, that is why which is considered forward bias and which is also called as a forward blocking state. Whenever we can give the gate supply to the gate terminal, okay, whenever we can give the gate supply to the gate terminal, then immediately the potential barrier will be immersed, then the conduction of the elements or the electrons will start moving from anode to the cathode. At that stage, the thyristor will operate in forward conduction mode. Okay, at that stage, the thyristor will operate in forward conduction mode. After that, if we connect vice versa, that means anode is connected to the negative terminal and cathode is connected to the positive terminal, then the thyristor is connected in reverse blocking stage. Reverse blocking state, even though some of the elements will flow, that is because of the non-minority particle, so what happens, immediately this thyristor will enter to the reverse blocking stage. Okay, now we will connect the or construct the a full wave rectifier. See, this rectifier is nothing but we need to convert an AC supply to the DC supply. So initially we need to assume an AC supply voltage, this is alternating current AC supply, and a full wave rectifier. Full wave rectifier is consisting of four thyristors. Okay, now I am taking four thyristors here, thyristor 1 and thyristor 4, thyristor 3, and this is your thyristor 2. Okay, these are the four thyristors. These should be connected in such a manner that all the terminals should be interlinked to each other. Now all the thyristors are connected. For this, what we are taking an R load we consider, that is why an R load I am taking here. This is your R load. This is your T1, T2, T3 and T4. Now we need to give supply phase and the neutral. I am taking that A, B, and this is Vs supply voltage and this is our V0 output voltage. Okay, now this is the simple construction of a full wave bridge rectifier which is having a
R load, which is having an R load.
Now what happened? The alternating supply is having a sinusoidal wave, isn't it? For the sinusoidal wave, assume that this is your sinusoidal wave. We are going to the working model of the full wave rectifier. So we are giving an alternating supply to the thyristors. For example, this is your alternating current having the time period omega t, voltage amplitude V0. Okay, this is our alternating sinusoidal waveform. So if you look into this waveform, the simple, a complete waveform consisting of the two cycles. One is a positive half cycle and one is negative half cycle. Okay, so by combining the two half cycles, we can call it as a complete waveform. So first of all, when the complete construction is completed, then assume that the first half cycle is enters into the circuit. Okay, and the first half cycle is enters into the cycle, that is this one, plus and minus for a positive half cycle. At this stage, this plus is connected to the anode and this minus is connected to the cathode of this T4. Now what happened? Thyristor T1, okay, thyristor T1 is forward operating mode, forward operating mode. Thyristor T2 is forward operating mode. Remaining the thyristors T3 and T4 are reverse blocking mode. So the path for the half cycle, positive half cycle path is Vs T1 R T2 and then Vs. This is the simple path for the flow of voltage in the rectifying circuit diagram. Now what happened? Until we are giving the thyristor gate pulse, the thyristor will not act in a forward conducting mode. So now what happened? We given the positive half cycle to the circuit. Now I am going to give the gate firing circuit at an angle of alpha. At an angle of alpha. Example that this is our gate pulse IZ. So this is the gate pulse for IZ1 and IZ2. And considering that IZ1 and IZ2 are the gating pulse for the thyristor T1 and for the thyristor T2 at an angle of alpha. Okay. Now, whenever we given the thyristor pulse to the thyristor, immediately the thyristor avalanche breakdown will break. Immediately the flow of electrons will continue from the anode to the cathode terminal. So, the output voltage or the output current waveform will be reflected for the first half cycle will be like this. See, until the alpha, the thyristor will be in not conducting mode. That means it is acts like a normal open circuit. So it will not reflect any value. Okay. It will not reflect any value. After that, we given the alpha firing angle, then immediately it starts conducting at an angle of alpha like this. Though the output will appear and the entire voltage will appear across the resistor. Entire voltage will appear across the resistor. That is why the same Vs value will reflect at the R. Now what happened to the current? What happened to the current? That is I naught is nothing but for the first half cycle, the same waveform will reflect. Why? Because whenever the thyristor will short circuit, immediately the current will flow to the load side. So like this it will happen. This is for the first half cycle. Now what about the triggering pulse, that is T1, voltage triggering V T1 V T2 for this. Now what happened? Positive half cycle is enters into the resistance is nothing but your load. So the entire voltage will appear on the resistor only. Small amount of voltage drops will be available at the thyristor because of the low value of the resistance which is having the thyristor. So, at this case, until we given the alpha firing angle, it will reflect like this. After that, it comes to the nearly zero value. After that, it comes to the zero value. Now, what happened to the T3 and T4, it will be in a negative reference value will come. Negative reference value will reflect like this. Like this it will come. This is the operation for the first positive half cycle only. Now what happened to the negative half cycle if we give? That means the vice versa operation will come like this. Isn't it? Minus and plus will come. Now what happened when this comes? This minus will come connected to the cathode of the T4 and the positive will connected to the anode of the T1. Now what happened? The thyristors T1 and then T2 are in reverse bias operation and the thyristor P3 and T4 are in forward biasing station. Therefore, for the path of negative half cycle, the path for the negative half cycle is Vs, Vs2, B, T3, R, T4, A, Vs. This is the simple path for the negative half cycle. So what happened? For the negative half cycle, the thyristors T1 and T2 are reverse blocking stage and the thyristors T3 and T4 are in forward operating mode. So until we given the firing angle, the thyristors will not conduct. So when we should give, for example, take pi plus alpha is your firing angle. Take pi plus alpha is your firing angle. This is your pi plus alpha. So up to that stage, this is your firing angle, right? Like this we given, and this is the firing angle for IG3 and IG4. Okay, now what happened? At this stage, the thyristor will start conducting for the negative half cycle, that is up to 2 pi. This is over 2 pi range. Okay, for this, the thyristors T3 and T4 will use the output. So, the entire output voltage will reflect at the load side. Okay, the entire output voltage will reflect at the load side. Like this, it will come. Like this, it will come. Similarly, the current value also will reflect at the load side after we giving the firing angle to the thyristors 3 and 4. Therefore, like this it will come. That is for the current waveform. Now, what happened to the thyristor voltage values? So, at this stage, what happens? The thyristors T1 and T2 are reverse blocking stage. Okay, the thyristors T1 and T2 are reverse blocking stage. At that stage, now what happened? This negative waveform will occur at here. The negative waveform will occur at the thyristors T1 and T2, and immediately this will be in a zero value. This will be in a zero value. This is the simple operation for the a full wave bridge rectifier with an R load. This is the simple operation. Now you can see this is up to the first cycle. What happened to the second cycle? The same operation will continue like this until the completion of the operation. This is 3 pi. This is 3 pi plus alpha for the thyristors T3 and T4. And this is the last firing pulse for the up to the value of 4 pi. This is T1, T2. This is T3, T4, gate firing angles, and this is the output waveform for the remaining two thyristors. This is the output current waveform, and this is your this one. And like this, it will come. This is for the voltage triggering pulse for the VT3 and V4. This is the omega T. This is the omega T. This is a simple operation. So what the condition is, nothing but instead of keeping the R load or instead of keeping the RL or RLC load, we can keep the drive system also. For that is nothing but your machine. If you keep in a machine, it is a very interesting topic to operate, and depending upon the firing angle, depending upon the supply range, the machine speed will reflect. Okay. So, in this way, we can easily explain the combination, construction and operation of an full wave bridge rectifier with an R load. Full wave bridge rectifier with an R load. Thank you very much.